First of all, I'd like to welcome everyone to the second annual No Place for Hate and Witness Inspire Act Talent Showcase. Before we start, we want to talk about the reason for having this, because it might seem kind of, it might be like, why am I here? So, we at No Place for Hate are different clubs, but we both believe deeply in having a strong community. And through art, music, and dance, and magic, and juggling, and other things that you will see tonight, caricatures, shout out to Jake DR, we're going to bring our heritage community together and celebrate what makes each of us awesome, okay? So both clubs came together to help our community come together.
And while this event will certainly be successful in bringing our community together, both No Place for Hate and WIA need to do more. If you look in the corner over there, we have selling smoothies, and the profits will go to fund a healthy eating program in a partner elementary school not so far from Southwest Philly. And then the money raised by donations during the next hour or two will also be donated to the National No Place for Hate organization, the Anti-Defamation League. And also the cool signs you're looking for over there next to the RAM are part of a new venture called the Heat Lab, or Heart and Energy Alternative Technology Laboratory, where students are raising money to fund their efforts to create real, clean, affordable energy technologies at and so as you spend the next hour and a half listening to your amazing friends, teachers, and peers, and looking at art and dance, and enjoying a smoothie or two, keep in mind that we are all here We're here not only to celebrate and build up our community, we're here also to improve it. And here's Ivy Maruka, and she's going to talk about the art that you guys see today.
Hi guys. Okay, so we're really lucky to have so much great art in the show tonight. Art's one of the many talents that people at Heritan have. And seeing how people enjoy and express themselves through making art can really help to bring a community together. And this setup wouldn't have been possible without Mr. Murray and the rest of the art faculty, as well as all of the amazing artists who contributed art to the show. The artist names can be found in your programs as well as next to all of their pieces. And so if you see them, make sure to thank them. And I'm just going to give it back to Nate.
All right, before we actually begin the talent portion, it's going to be in a minute, I forgot to introduce myself. I'm Nate, that's Daida, that's Ibby. We're going to be emceeing tonight. Thanks, guys. Okay, so now we're going to start with the talent. Just a quick shout out before we continue. Over in the corner, you might have seen our resident magician, Lincoln Green. He's awesome. If you haven't seen him, check him out. I'm sure he'll do an awesome trick for you. Good job, man. Also, over in the other corner, we have Jake Diamond-Rajevich doing caricatures. They're gonna be something, so yeah, you should definitely check that out also at some point during the show. Okay, and with that, I'd like to introduce our first act. We're gonna have a song called Dream a Little Dream, presented to you by Victoria Alfred Laveau and Mr. Warren. Let's get up.
Your kiss. weeds find you. Sweet dreams that leave all worries behind you.
Here, oh, here, I ask myself.
Thanks. Up next, we have Hannibal with the Phonic Sound.
Thank you.
here to perform Chasing Cars is Karen Katz and Zach Alfred Lavelle.
If I could have chosen a list of acts, which I would call it, the juggling definitely would not be wrong. Yeah, it's great.
It was awesome.
Thank you. death row pardon, 2 minutes too late, and isn't it ironic?
Special relativity, Einstein has three major concepts that come from it. Space-time, gravitational time dilation, length, you all understand it. So basically, we can use this to just apply this to all of our life now. Oh, I got this, all right. So I guess I can't explain it in 2 minutes because I've gotten some signals from some higher powers that told me not to. I'm getting this from the back, this from the back. So I'm gonna go to my second talent, which is reading off of note cards. Hopefully I don't bore you. Thank you. Okay, allow me to begin my amazing talent. No Place for Hate is a community organization that believes in respecting and treating others fairly. Witness Inspire Act strives to create awareness for global injustices, atrocities, and inequalities while creating meaning for those involved. Our electricity and magnetism classes here at Herndon, under the supervision, yours truly, Mr. Yumizumi. Round of applause for that. Allow me to take this moment to shout out Miss Mark Houston, wherever she is. Hold it down. Thank you. So we've used these two mission statements in conjunction with our education. Over the past few months, we've been working on several different projects for HEAT, meaning Herndon Energy Alternative Technologies. We in HEAT wish to provide opportunities for those in disadvantaged areas to benefit from electricity. We aim to create viable ways of generating alternative electricity with easily accessible resources. Now, I don't really need these anymore. So I'm just gonna talk about some of the projects we've been working on. Let's see. We got the elevator. So what we're gonna try and do is we're gonna use human mass to create electricity. You can find more information over there. I'll be doing this a lot. Okay, the next thing we have is the thermocouple. So what happens is there's a difference in temperatures and this creates electricity. Once again, more information. Oh, bear with me 2 seconds. I'm almost done, I promise. Then you have the wheelchair. The wheelchair, now the way this works is that you have someone who spins the wheel and it goes boom, 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 and it goes boom, boom, boom. Well, see, I would be able to do that if I wasn't standing up here with a mic on the stage and boring half of you to death. But basically, the rotational energy from the wheel generator turns a motor, generating electricity. Find more information? There. And finally, we have the bicycle, which uses the power of this leg. Just one. Just like this. I can do this all day long. Generate electricity. All right, sorry about that. So you basically turn the wheel, and then you're turning a motor, and then you generate electricity. Find more information over there. Thank you for listening to me. I am now going to turn the mic over into the hands of another fellow student, Junior Eitan Ginsberg, who will be explaining how we establish HEAT. Thank you.
There are 7 billion of us in the world today, and we're facing some huge problems. But talk doesn't help someone out of poverty. Awareness doesn't reduce pollution, or grow food, or heal the sick. That takes doing. 3 billion people lack electricity, 800 million go to bed hungry, 50,000 children die of poverty each day, 1 in 9 people don't have access to clean water. While we relish in our wealth and happiness, and our biggest concern is what prestigious university we're accepted in, much of the world struggles to survive. It's time for us to take a stand through our action. The cardinal idea for this project came from Manoj Bhargava, the CEO of 5-Hour Energy with a $4 billion net worth. After dropping out of Princeton, living in ashrams in India for 12 years and dedicating 99% of his wealth to charity, Manoj founded Billions in Change, an organization aimed at tackling 3 of the world's most pressing problems. His film, which depicts an energy bike that generates electricity with zero pollution, inspired the premise of our project, harnessing human power as a sustainable energy resource. Tackling the world's problems requires all of us, as a community, to stand in solidarity. We are in our physics classrooms are communities which welcome anyone on board to join the fight. 1 billion starts with one, but it ends with many. Come join us.
Great Zach Alfred LeBeau
performing an original song.
It's not an original.
all heard a lot of talking, but I have to specially tune this guitar, so you're gonna hear some more talking. Well, anyway, I haven't done this sort of thing in like 3 years, and I gotta say, it is really, really nice to do this again. You guys are a lovely audience. Keep the awkward silence going. I should probably prepare some jokes for getting up here. But the only joke I can think of right now is my physics grade. It's funny because it's true. I'm halfway there, living on a prayer. Called Mad World by the band Tears for Fears.
Awesome, Zach. Really great. Hey, Zach.
Hey.
you're super talented, man, wherever you are. I actually would have to put you in my top three talented alpha libos, if I'm being honest. Up next, we have another alpha libo, Sarah alpha libo, who's going to be playing the piano for us. Let's give it up for Sarah, guys.
Infection. Stress being believed. least basic being unleashed. Heart rates increase, and the strength of keeping my humanity decrease. Injections of affection lead me to wrong direction. Reflections of perfection to save different sections of my very own hell. His resurrections of your connections are not happy, nor a peaceful state of mind. I look up to light and find myself blind. I'm not just going to unwind, try to find myself. Maybe I might go on the show, but not after all. I believe I may have some kind of disease where I feel like I'm burning 195 degrees on fire. Heat on the outside, while on the inside, I begin to freeze. Is this some kind of contagion, mutation, or even some invasion? An invasion of demons into the soul, but first to enter, they must pay. So many things that they have offered. Impurities, hypocrisy, sick I am. If only it was all a scam. Dreams, nightmares, seeing myself sitting alone at tables, disappearing into the darkness after some piece of work tore my heart, to show the spectators the struggle in the background, mocking me, saying it's not compared to my head. Day one, bad dreams turn to bad dreams. Day 50, attractions, extractions, tiny pieces of my heart. Day 75, walking into a maze, only to find myself awake from the grave. Day 99, with beautiful piano tune, spinning and spinning and spinning, wanting, craving. Day 100, gone.
Be familiar with this very, 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 very special person. But when I heard she was in town, I had to see if she would join us today. And honestly, I think if it weren't for her, I don't think actually this evening would actually be taking place right now. Her name is Avery Bernstein, and she's a recent Harrison graduate. And she founded a club called Gems Not Genocide, and it's when she was in seventh grade, and she was just inspired by this movie, and that's how it all started. And then all of a sudden, it became this huge, huge movement in this school that turned into WEA just a few years after that. So, and she actually believes also that music is something that brings communities together, and. I'm gonna bring her up so she can sing a song she agreed to sing, and it's an original, something that she wrote. So Avery Bernstein, please come to the stage.
I'm a sophomore at the George Washington University, so I graduated, and I'm sure a lot of you guys are waiting back to hear back from schools. Breathe, you're all gonna be extremely happy wherever you go. And I'm actually starting a program next semester called Guitars Not Guns to mitigate gun violence in DC schools. So I think music really does bring people together, and I think it's
really a part of healing and social change. So I'm going to be playing a song that I wrote last year called Letting Go. Thank you.
Squares, placing them where that sun could touch them in hopes that it would carry them away. I wanted to show you the ghosts I found outside my window, the lingering apparitions of the pine trees with all their sewing needle leaves, and the what was oak tree with all its dead seeds. I wanted to tell you about how I ate graham crackers and coffee like ambrosia and nectar, how I hid my fingers in my ratty sweatshirt sleeves, how I wore paint-streaked skinny jeans when they were unmarked sweatpants. I wanted to tell you about how that October sun, I wanted to tell you about how that October sun came into our gray blinds and stretched itself across the tile so slowly that I thought time had stopped, and for a second I could breathe. I wanted to show you how I wore a green jacket and black Converse, how I smelled like last winter, like dirty dugouts and freezing rain, how they said I looked like heartbreak and smiled just like you used to. I wanted to show you how... I wanted to show you how I curled up on that red couch in the library with the devil by my side, how the trees outside are turning the color of your eyes and the wind tastes like your lips, and how the leaves are furling like calves against thighs, and I keep hearing blue jay calls that sound just like you. I wanted to tell you, but I couldn't. You have been blind for as long as I can remember, and your ears were bitten by ruined by a frostbite that I cannot save you from. Fall rolls around like a death sentence for you, so I place flowers on your grave and I tattoo my wrist with crosses and hope you don't resurrect. But if you do, maybe I can show you how much I love autumn this year.
A human being between the ages of alive and dead. So chances are you're already there. Congratulations. Step two, fall in love. People will tell you that this takes years, but we have a secret method that will allow you to fall for anyone in under a week. The secret is, you must be completely unable to tell the difference between love and codependence. Step three, fall in love. Someone else. At the same time. People will tell you this is impossible, given the love already inside you, but they don't know you. Your heart is limitless. Your heart is a well that goes all the way down. You can fit everyone in there, but remember to lie about it. Love can't exist with knowledge of other love. Step four. At this point, you're probably doubting your decision to totally screw up your life. So ask yourself, would you rather be happy or interesting? Would you rather be on the news or just watching it? Happy people don't make history. Happy people make children, then die. Step five, self-diagnose a mental disorder that makes you aloof and impossible to contact. If someone accuses you of being a bad friend, lover, or child, accuse them of being insensitive. Step 7. Oh, step 6. That's the end. Step 6. All the elements are in place. Now, start sabotaging your own life. Remember, this isn't crazy. This is research. This is material. This is important for your self-growth. Step 7. You've been in love with two people for a while now. Tell them about each other. Whichever one stays is the winner. Step 8. Call your boss a fascist chipmunk lover. Tell your friends fun lies about your other friends. Tell your mother she's the reason you tried to kill yourself. It's just not depression without total isolation. Step 9. Do something to hurt yourself. It may be credit card debt. It may be gonorrhea. It may be a razor. Literal or not, make yourself bleed. Step 10. Create something. Paint your scars on the side of a building. Write a poem and shout it at strangers. The misery circus is parading into town and you are holding the banner. Miles of people are following you. They are all wearing gray, a rainbow of gray. They are all watching as they kick themselves bloody on their own feet. You have scars and everyone wants to kiss them. This is passion of infamy. This is inspiration. You are the reason they are still alive. You are mourning in a world of midnights. You are so brave, and they want to be brave just like you. Look at what you've built. Everything you've loved is gone. Tell yourself it was worth it.
Touch my soul. Okay. Real quick before we move on, I'd like to give a birthday shout out. Abby is here. Abby turned 13. Can we have Abby, everyone? Congrats. Okay. All right. Up next, I'm going to ask you guys to clear to the center a little bit. Just move back. No dance? Never mind. You're good where you are. Vanessa Hall is going to perform a song and dance for us. Possibly not again. Okay, thanks.
I'm gonna go.
get everybody in the mood for Christmas, Miss Harper will be performing Have Yourself a Merry Little Christmas.
So, I think they need time to set up, so I'm going to stall for them for a little bit. I just wanted to say thank you, especially to the guys who are great tonight, but to the women who performed tonight, unbelievable courage. I'm like so thrilled that my daughters were sitting here watching that. Like each time somebody went up, one of them would say, Mommy, can I do that? Like, can I play the guitar? I'm like, yeah. Can I play the piano? Uh-huh. Can I read a poem? Yeah. And write one? You know, whatever you want, whatever you want. So this is Have Yourself a Merry Little Christmas. Are you guys ready? So this is the version from the movie Meet Me in St. Louis, which is an old, okay, thank you. This is from 1944. And it's the lyrics are a little bit different than the ones that Frank Sinatra did, because he made it kind of holly and jolly. And it was actually about missing people at Christmas time and trying to stay happy even though you knew.
Have yourself a merry little Christmas. Let your heart be light. Next year all our troubles will be out of sight. A merry little Christmas. Make the Yuletide gay. Next year all our troubles will be miles away. Once again, as in olden days, happy golden days of yore. Faithful dear to us, will be near to us once more. Someday soon, we all will be together, if the fates allow. Until then, we'll have to muddle through somehow. So have yourself
Okay, so now that you're in the winter spirit, we're gonna keep it going with more Christmas songs. Here's a song, Summertime. Okay.
Bye.
not need an introduction. Give it up for Candy Rapper performing Lose Yourself.
Hey. Thank you.
Kayla. You made me lose myself. Oh no, I'm all alone. Let's give it up for Mr. Warren singing Lonely Boy.
Lonely road, the only one that I have. empty street on the boulevard of broken dreams, where the city sleeps and I'm the only one out.
Drinking my Zumi smoothie. Refreshments are closing soon, so if you want to get food, go grab some. We still got some great stuff left. Okay, we're coming to the end of the night. We have two acts left. Up next, we have Take Me to Church, sung by the amazing Kate Rinde. Let's give it up for her.
Take me to church, y'all, so I can know that I'm
amazing job. Very true, too. And with that, we're going to wrap up the talent portion of the show. Feel free to hang out. You can continue looking at art. We're going to be cleaning up, so talk to the performers if you want. Talk to the artists. We have some food left over there. Someone will be selling that if you want to buy something. We'd like to thank everyone who performed tonight and everyone who helped setting up. Like to thank everyone who put time and effort into making this possible.
And specifically, this night would be impossible without Mr. Evislav, Mr. Ferguson, Ms. Markusen, Mr. Imaizumi, Mr. Murray, Mr. Warren, Mr. Solosky, Ms. Harper, and Dr. Havlik. So our sincere thanks to all of you, and also a shout out to No Place for Hate and VIA Club members for helping along with key lab engineers and scientists. You guys all rock. Thank you very much.
Yeah, shout out to JTR for caricatures. Thanks a ton for coming. We hope you had as much fun as we did. Feel free to donate more on the way out. I know Heat Labs could use some donations, or just to We at No Place for Hate in general. Yeah, thanks for coming.